Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. Hope you are doing great. I am back with another problem from LeetCode today. Reorder list. So we are given with a singly linked list L, L0, L1 until LN-1, LN. So there are N elements, or we can say N plus 1 elements in the list, right? So we need to reorder it to L0, LN, L1, LN-1, L2, LN-2, and so on. So basically, whatever the last element that we have, that is LN, right? So that we have to put in between L0 and L1. The second last element, that is LN-1, we have to put that in between second and third element. Likewise, so if we look at the example, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, if that is a list, right? So 4 should go between 1 and 2, right? 4 went 1 and 2. So 3 should go, but 3 itself is the element, but between 2 and 3 there is no element. Otherwise 3 would have been gone into that element. Let's go look at the example 2, which will be odd length. So first, example 1 is the even length, right? This is an odd length. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So 1, 2, so between 1, 2, the last element, that is 5 will go. So 1, 5, 2 it will be. Between 2 and 3, the next last is 4, that 4 will go. Between 2 and 3, the 4 will go. So that is what the problem is. So this is a very simple problem as it appears. But one thing that caution that we are given is, you may not modify the values in the list nodes. Only nodes itself may be changed. So it's not like you copy the entire array, like let's say entire numbers into an array, 1, 2, 3, 4 into a separate space, and then make, while going through this linked list, which you just copy it, 1, 4, 2, 3, something like that, right? So you are not allowed to do that. So basically we have to change the links between the nodes in the linked list, but we are not allowed to copy this entire list into array and then put the elements back into the list. So this is not allowed. So for this purpose, right, what we are going to do is, we are going to first need the length of the array, right? So basically we length of the list, not array. So we need the length of the list so that the second half of the elements will go as the elements into the first half. Let's go look at the example 2, right? So in this, there are 5 elements. So these 3 will be staying as is, but these are the elements will be going into the different positions. So that means half of the list will be changed. Basically, the links for the half of the list will be changed. For that case, what we are going to do is, we need to go find exactly the midpoint in the list and store and have something for all these points, right? Right? So we could solve in a very good way this one. So once we know we have reached the midpoint of the list, that is at 3, right? So whatever the elements that come after the midpoint, they will be changing their places, right? But the thing is, they will be changing their places such that the last element will be changing the place first. Here in this case, the number 5 will change its place first. Number 4 will change its place next. So like that. So this looks like a last in, first out, right? So last in, first out kind of strip. So this is very well suited for a stack data structure. So what we are going to do is, we will use a stack here to store all the elements which are after the midpoint, right? So we will break this link after the midpoint, and once we break this link, we will come starting from here, from the first node, and we pop the elements from the stack and put the elements from the stack into the list again so that we re-establish the links between those elements, right? So let's go look at the code for this, right? So the very simple code here. So we are going to use the stack for this, right? A stack with all the list nodes. And then what we are going to first identify is we need to identify the first element, that not the first element, the midpoint, right? So once we know the midpoint, then we will be able to store the rest of the list into a stack. So if there are only one element or zero element or two elements, right, we don't need to do anything into the list. For example, if the list is only that much, right, you don't need to do anything. But if the list is only one, we don't need to do anything. So for that case, if head is not equal to null and head dot next is also not equal to null, in that case, then only we enter this code path. So here, this piece of code will find us the midpoint of the list. So what we are going to do here is we are going to have two things. One is slow pointer and one is fast pointer. So slow pointer is initialized to head and fast pointer is initialized to head dot next. So slow will move one step at a time, but fast will move two steps. So while slow will move one step at a time, fast will move two steps at a time. So when fast is moving at a double speed, right? So when fast is at the end of it, slow will be at the middle of the list. So that is a technique here that we are going to use. So when once this while loop exits, right? So slow, wherever the slow stops, that is when we are in the middle of the list. So now, so that we are going to get the middle of the list into temp. So after this middle of the list, right? We don't want the rest of the list to be part of the current list. So what we are going to do is move the slow pointer to the next list and make the temp to temp.next to null. That means we broke the list into the first list and the second list, basically. So from till the midpoint, there is one list. After the midpoint, there is one list. So till the midpoint, the list is already broken. So after the midpoint, the list starts at the slow pointer. So now, while slow is not equal to null, we are going to push all the elements into the stack, right? So in this particular example, 4 and 5 will be pushed into the stack. So now, since 4 and 5 are at the stack, now we will go back to the head, the first node. So we'll go back to head, we'll store that into the temp, and while s dot count is greater than 0. That means if stack has any elements, right? So if the stack has any elements and the temp is not equal to null, we are going to pop the element from the stack, that is top of the stack, and insert after our next node. Sorry, after our temp node, right? So we will call the next node as temp dot next, right? So one, if in case of 1 and 2, 1 is pointing to temp, 2 is pointing to the next node, that is temp.next. So the temp is pointing to node 1. So, but now what we want temp to point to? Temp.next to be pointing to the top. So the top is 5, right? That's what we popped. So now that's where we establish a link between 1 and 5. So temp.next is equal to top. But after that is the establishing link between 1 and 5. Now we have to establish a link between 5 and 2. So that this one will take care. Top dot next. So 5 dot next is equal to next node. What was the next node? It is 2, right? And our next node to look at will be put into the temp. So the 2 will be put into temp. So the next one, when we go back to the while loop, right? So that will be 2. So by now, what we have got is this one after the first iteration, right? After the first iteration, this has been established. So now next, no, the temp is pointing to 2. So since temp is not equal to null and stack has an element, we will go through this again. So finally, that since there is no need to return any element and anything here, so whatever the head that we are pointing, that will still, that is still staying same. So this will be working as per the solution that we are expecting. So let's look at the time complexity for this. Time will be, since we are going through the full linked list 2 times, right? So one is in the first pointer slow pointer case, and another one is the while loop. So even though in this case we are just going through the half of the list, because another half is already in the stack, right? We are going through the half list, right? So we will say, even though we are going n by 2, that is assuming that n elements are there in the list, we are going through this loop n by 2 times, and we are going through this list this n times. Technically, we are going through this n by 2 as well, because slow is going at one pointer each time and faster is going two times, right? So we could say technically we are looking at n by 2 elements, but since big O notation is all about the non-constants, right? So order of, we'll say n by 2, but which is, it'll boils down to order of n. So that is what we are going to call. So it is, time complexity is order of n. So like, let's look at the space complexity, right? So space complexity, for we are using the extra stack space here, right? So the stack space, as we said, we are going to store the half of the list. So if the list length is n, half of the list is the stack space that we are going to use. So half of the list is n by 2 again. So we will call this also order of n, since big O notation removes the constants when we say complexity, right? But this is only the document complexity, but perceived complexity for space is still order of n by 2 only. For time also order of n by 2 only. Since the big O notation deals with non-constants, we'll just say order of n time and order of n space for this problem. Hope you like the solution and the video. If you like it, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get all the notifications for my future videos. Please share among your friends. Thanks for watching. I will be back with another video very soon. Thank you.